Good morning, dear students. Myself Girish Shias. Today we are going to do assembly of plumber block component. So previously we did the part drawing of plumber block component. I save that in this folder. Here you see in the desktop CAMD folder. Inside the CAMD folder assembly, inside that plumber block, I saved all the component here. So we need to do assembly of that. Assembly of the part we created. For that you need to double click on this assembly. Okay, after that assembly page will open. Okay, assembly page will open. Okay, so here we need to go for the part we already created to that destination. Here this is the tree edge bar where you can see all the activities what we are doing in this screen. This is the part library. You have to go for part library here. If in the earlier case, if edge bar is closed, it will not open here. Okay, we need to make sure that in the tools section, you have to click on switch the edge bar so that it will open. Here, second one, blue color, what we see in part library, you have to go there. So I saved in this CAMD folder, open that, assembly, number block, you open that. So first component is body, you have to hold this and drag it on the screen. Okay, so the part will come and sit on the screen. So on top of that you have to do the assembly. I will choose bearing bottom off, second one. Okay, so that this pattern will make it easy for assembling all the other component. So I will select this. So I will rotate in the below screen. What you see, if you click on this, the part will come in the below screen. If you just click on this component. Okay, so I will select bearing bottom off. So by holding the center scroll screen of the mouse, you can rotate this for the required position. I need this position, it has to attach here. So by holding this bearing bottom off, if you drag it down here, it will occupy this position. Okay, so it will come here. So here various relation, this is the assembly relationship option or command. In that here it will, in the different relationship will be given. So you have to select one particular relationship in order to arrest the degrees of freedom. Okay, so degrees of freedom is nothing but number of coordinate to describe the motion of a body. Okay, that is called degrees of freedom. In a, if a body is placed in the free space, if it is freely spaced, it has 6 degrees of freedom. Okay, you see here, in the move option here, you have linear degree of freedom. Okay, in x axis, x, y and z axis, you have 3 degrees of freedom along the x axis, y axis and z axis. Rotational also, you have along the x axis the component will rotate, y axis and z axis also rotate. If it is freely spaced, you have to arrest these degrees of freedom so that the component can be assembled, so that it will not move, the position will be arrested by defining the relationship, this one. Okay, assembly relationship. So I will select for this component. You also follow the same procedure. I will show when you are doing, we will come to understand some of the relationship. Majority of the relationship what we used in assembly of the basic component is axial alignment and flash bit. Sometime mate also. Most commonly use axial alignment and flash bit. Axial alignment is here we use axial alignment for this component. Select axial alignment. I want to make sure that axis of this. So this is the extension part, what you see, axis of this and axis of this one, the small hole what we prepared, it has to come along the same line. See, carefully you have to click this. So when you click, these two axes will come along the same line. See here, so for this extruded part of 5 mm extruded part, this one and this one will come along same line. So now we arrested what degrees of freedom here. So how you arrested? So this part can only move up and down along this axis. Okay, you cannot rotate, or it cannot move in this direction. You cannot move in this direction, because if you try to move either left or right, these two, this axis and this axis will change. We already described the relationship such a way that this will not change the axis. Axis of this one and axis of this one will comes along the same line. Okay, like that you have to arrest. So by retaining this axial alignment, you only can move up and down, so that this axis and this axis will come same. Okay, if other movement will be arrested. Okay, similarly you have to do one more relationship, another type axial relationship I will select. See, axis of this, you have a curved portion here, axial alignment, you have a curved portion. Axis of this and axis of this should be matched. Okay, like this if you align. So I given 2 degrees of freedom. One is, so this curve axis of the body and curve axis, this axis, this axis, these all are come along same axis. As we use axis symmetry for producing this component, all these lines having same axis. Any line you can select and give axial alignment, so that you will achieve this. Okay, so like that you have to give. So for this component to be fit properly, you need to give 2 axial alignment. Okay, so I will show it again. You see, first what you will do, I drag it on the screen. Second component I will drag it on the screen. So select this axial alignment, axis of this one and axis of this one. First I will give, then again axial alignment, axis of any of this curve, this one, this one, these are all same. Okay, same axis it is having. So anyone you select, axis of this and axis of this should be matched. Like that you have to do. Okay, so the bearing bottom off will be fixed on the body now. So next I will select bearing top off. So here also same way you have to do. So what I will do, so I will hold this and rotate particular position by holding the scroll button of the mouse. Okay, like this it is, you will rotate to required position, and by holding this bottom half, drag it and place it on the top of the screen like this. So now you have to arrest the degrees of freedom. So how I am going to do is, so here I will use another type of relationship. First I will give axial alignment. Axial alignment, axis of this should match with axis of this. Okay, like this it will come. So again I will use one more thing. Now you can move this component. See here, by selecting this component you can move it along this. See, even you are moving here, so I will move it some distance. If you see the front view, see this axis and this axis will same. Even you can rotate also. See, you can rotate about the axis like this, but you cannot change the axis of these two. Okay, you can move or rotate along the same axis. Other movement will be restricted. If you try to move this component, okay, linearly, it will move along the axis forward and backward. You cannot lift this component up, because if you try to lift this component, this body axis and this part axis will change. So as we already define the relationship, that will not going to happen. Okay, like that you make axis symmetry. And I will give one more thing, and now I will use flash fit. You see flash fit option, flash fit of this surface. Flash fit is used to match the two surface along the same plane. So this surface, okay, and here the flash fit of this one, these two will come along same plane. So now you see the view, front view. See, this surface and this surface will come along the same plane. Now if you try to rotate, it cannot rotate. Why? Because, so if you rotate, what happen? These two surface, this top surface and this surface will change. That's why it cannot rotate. Now you see in the side view. See, though it is far away, so these two axes remain same, and this surface, flat surface, and this surface will come along the same line, same plane. Flash fit is nothing but two surface will come along the same plane. Now I am given flash fit for this surface. Flash fit for this surface, whatever you see the surface and this surface. So this bottom surface, these two surface will come along the same plane. So now I will give one more flash fit. You see here. So first I give axial alignment, then I give flash fit. Then I will give one more flash fit. Flash fit of this surface with this surface. This one. See now. So now it will align properly. So keep it in diametry and see now. Okay, now it is aligned. What I did? First I will give axial alignment of this curve and this curve. So both will come along same axis. Then flash fit of this surface and bottom surface. Okay, I will give, and then flash fit of this surface and this surface I give. So complete, it will be assembled properly. You cannot change, you cannot move now, because I already constrained all 6 degrees of freedom. I constrained. Okay, so this body cannot move now. Okay, like this you have to do. So now I will. So three component already assembled: body, bearing, top off and bottom off. Already assembled. Now I will bring the cap. This is cap. Okay, I will bring the cap. So click and hold the cap and place it on the above screen. So don't place it like this, because it has to come above. If you place it like this, if you define relationship, the component may go inside this body. You cannot visible properly. So that's why this cap, you have to place it above this. Like this you place. Fit. So now I will give two relationship. Just two relationship I will give. See what happen. So I will give axial alignment of. So along this hole, the bolt will go, right? So I will give axial alignment for this hole and this hole, and axial alignment for this hole and this hole. From here we will feed the oil for lubrication. From here it will go inside this. If you give axial alignment for this one and this one, this one and this one, it will fit properly. You see here, flash fit. Sorry, axial alignment, axis of this and axis of this one. Okay, so now again you see axis of this and axis of this one you need to select. So you also give this axial alignment is given, you also give axial alignment of other wall. See here, this axis, this one. Carefully you have to select this. Okay, zoom, better zoom the area. Now you can select axis of this with axial alignment, axis of see, once again I will give the relationship. See here, select this axial alignment, axis of this one. Try to zoom that axis of this one, fit, and then you select axis of this. So it will, these two wall comes along same axis. Again you select this axis of this, any one of this, this one or this one, axis of this with axis of, by rotating this like this you will keep. So now these three walls, I given this axis and this axis alignment. So if these two axes are aligned, so obviously this axis will also align. So one more thing I will give here, you see, so axial alignment, three axial alignment required here. Axial alignment of this curve, this one with this one. So now it will over. Assembly of cap will be over. If you put it in front view, you see this gap has to be maintained. So in your assembly, if these two surface will join, that means it is wrong. Okay. So what I did, axis of these two axis I aligned, these two axis I aligned. Here one hole will come, this axis and this axis I aligned. Then I will give axis of this curve and axis of this curve. Okay. So if you open the drawing sheet, you see here. So this axis is, you see, axis of this component. I will zoom and show. See here. So axis of this curve will be 6 mm below this surface. So that's why when you give axial alignment of this one and this one, so this 6 mm gap has to be maintained. So that is what you can see here. So when you do this assembly, this 6 mm gap has to be maintained. So like that you can do the cap assembly. What you did, so you click and drag the cap. First you give axial alignment of this hole and this hole, then axial alignment of this hole and bottom hole, aisle hole. So then you give axial alignment of this curve and this curve. If you give, so it will fit properly. Okay, so now body is over, bearing top of bottom of over, cap will be over. Now what you have to do, so I have to select bolt has to be assembled. So select the bolt. When you are doing the assembly of bolt, so better you hide the plane as of now. So if you can hide the plane, it will be better. Select button, choose select button if it is not selecting me. So hide the planes, you can hide it later, you can show. If you click show, it will be shown. So you have to go to this first option, you will get reference plane. Right click on the reference plane, you hide this while you are assembling that component bolt. So hide the plane, it will be easy. So then I will come to part library, I will select the bolt. So place this bolt bottom of this. The bolt has to come from the bottom, right? So place it at the bottom like this. Okay, so then you define the relationship. So bolt, this hole, axial, you have to do axial alignment of this hole and this hole for the bolt. So axial alignment of this hole and this hole, so you have to do this. And then one axial alignment is there, then you have to do two flash fit. I will show flash fit of this internal surface. You see here, flash fit of this surface. First I will select this surface. Okay, so bolt bottom surface and then this surface. So this is after creating a square hole on that part, we will get the bottom surface. You have to select. So then it will align now. Okay, so now you given the flash fit of these two. Okay, so now again you before that it is better to give so flash fit of this rather than bottom of the bolt and this flash fit. So I will give flash fit of this, so the bolt will be aligned properly. Flash fit of this surface with this, see what happened. So when you give that, so alignment will come clearly. You see here. So this surface and this surface align properly. Now after that you give under flash fit of this surface, square surface and this surface. You have to do carefully. Now it will fit properly. Like this you have to do. Okay. So I will repeat this. See here. After dragging this one bolt underneath that. It is showing in different view as I rotate it. So what I will do, select the assembly relationship, select axial alignment, axial alignment of this hole. So it will completely from here, top to bottom. You can select this one, and with this, any two, it will be same axis. Axial alignment of this one with this one. Okay, so it will come along the same axis. So then use flash fit of the side surface with one of the side surface here. So it will rotate. So then again use flash fit of this surface. Underneath surface and this surface. So it will place properly. Now you keep it in diametry. So bolt will be assembled. Okay, no need to assemble both the bolts. If all these components are same, you can use mirror option later. I will assemble only one bolt. On top of the bolt, you will get lock nut. Nut first. Then on top of nut, you will get lock nut. So what I will do? So click on the nut. Drag and place it above this bolt. Okay, so for assembling the nut to bolt, what you will do, first you have to do axial alignment of bolt hole and nut hole. You have to do, I already selected nut hole axis, so axis axial alignment of nut hole and bolt cylinder. So then it will come along the same axis. Then you have to select flash fit of underneath the bolt surface and top surface of this. So in art like this you have to do. Okay, after assembling the nut on the bolt, so you have to select lock nut and click and drag on the screen above the bolt. So here what you have to do, again same as how you joined the nut to the bolt, similarly you do axial alignment for lock nut axis and bolt axis. Okay, so now you make the axis same. You can move it in order to make it easy for assembly. Select this, you can move along the x axis, along this axis you can move. Then flash fit of top surface of the bottom surface of the lock nut and top surface of the bolt. You have to do in order to make it these two already aligned, as I saved in diametry all the parts before saving. So if you give flash fit of this and this surface, it will position properly. Like that you have to do. Okay, so after that what you have to do, so as already you assembled bolt nut and lock nut, so again you have to do it on the right side. So you no need to repeat that procedure. What I will do, previously I hide the plane, right? So by clicking the select button, click on the right click on the reference plane. Now you use show option, so your plane will be visible. So then fit to the screen. I want to do mirror. Select solid mirror. You have mirror component option here. Mirror component. Select this. So it will ask. Click on the assembly reference plane to mirror above. I want to mirror these three components: bolt, nut, and lock nut above this plane. Select this plane. Okay. I will repeat here. You see, mirror. I will select this plane. Now it will ask. Click on the component. Either you can click it here, or you can click it here itself. So I will click it here. So I want to select bolt. Okay, no need to hold the control button here. It will select multiple component: bolt, nut, and lock nut. All these three I have to mirror. So after selecting this, suggest you say okay in the right mark. You say click on the right mark. So then okay here, then finish. So this will be, these three component will be mirror on the other side of this plane. Like this you have to do. When you have same component, you have to assemble in opposite to the particular plane. So then you can use like this. Okay, so now, so body I already use, then bearing bottom off, bearing top off I used, cap I use, bolt nut, lock nut I use. Only thing left is, so here you can see, I used body, okay, I used bearing top off, bottom off, bolt, cap, lock nut, I already used all this. Only thing left is shaft. So what you do, shaft, drag it on the screen. So then give axial alignment of axis of the shaft and axis of this. Okay, then you give flash fit of this, flash fit of one of this surface and this one. So now the shaft will be fitted properly. So this will complete the assembly of the plumber block component. Okay, so now this is complete the assembly of the plumber block component. If you see the part drawing sheet, so usually plumber block will ask like this. Okay, so half sectional front view they ask. You need to create a section. After assembly you have to show sectional front view of a component. In order to do that, after creating assembly, what you have to do is you save this assembly, save as. So I already defined the folder. Okay, so here assembly, you save it like this. Okay, so after saving this, I want to do sectional front view. I have to take. So here in this toolbar you see PMI option. So go to PMI option, select in PMI option, last but one you have section option. Select this section, select the top view. For our requirement here I will select top view. So half sectional front view you have to do. So here you select rectangle. Okay, rectangle you select. I want to cut this portion from the center. Just drag a line, select rectangle from the center. I want to delete half sectional view. So front view only, in front view I have to delete half of the section. So draw this rectangle like this. I will show, repeat, I'll repeat, select the rectangle option, click on this center button. So click on the end of this assembly and click down so that it will cover all the front part. Like this you select, then you give return. So then it will ask whether you have to delete inside this rectangle or outside the rectangle. I want to delete inside this rectangle. So click on inward direction, click like this, and then you drag upward so that it will cover complete one. Okay, like up to it will cover the height. You have to drag it like this. Okay, then preview. So see here, so front view of section will be taken. So now we have to save this file. Save as assembly. I already saved assembly. You take assembly section, you change the name assembly section. Like this you can save. So now this it will complete. Here you see, you can see oil hole here. So it will we are adding the oil from here. So then it will come and place here. So alignment, you can see axial alignment will be properly done. Okay, you can see it has to be like this. So now what you have to do, so now 3D model is created, assembly is done, section is already taken. So now we have to extract all this to 2D sheet. So how to extract? So go to the file here, select new. In that you have to select the second one. 2D sheet means drafting. Second one select, okay. Okay, so now part drawing sheet will be open. So now we have to do sheet setup, how you did in our previous classes, sheet setup, switch off the show background, okay. So then save default, okay. So then you can, this is saved in A4 sheet. So now I have to extract that sectional component, assembly section into 2D sheet. For that you have below the select command, you have drawing view wizard option. Drawing view wizard option, you have to click this drawing view wizard. So if you click the page will plumber block page, or if it is not open, you choose the destination path where you save, it will open. Initially it will be, suppose if it is only part document, so now only parts will open, okay. So you don't worry like part is disappear, because here it is only part document is given, that's why it is only showing part document. Here in the files type you have to change all solid edge model. If it is by default it will be part document, you have to change to all solid edge model. So then everything will be appear. So then I have to select assembly section as the as good sectional front view also, you have to select assembly section. So then open. So then a new window will appear, drawing view creation wizard window. You have to just say next option. So then the named views, it will ask what are the view required. So I don't want this standard view, I will customize the view. For that you just click on the custom. Same procedure for all the, after creating assembly and after taking the section, if they ask in the exam, same procedure will follow. So then you go for customize view. So in that it will come, a new window will appear, you close that window. So then it will ask drawing view layout, what are the view you want. You have to select this. This is front view, this is top view, this is side view. Like this you have to select L shape. From the middle you select L shape. After clicking on these three, then you give save finish. So now whatever you selected, it is coming in 1:5 scale. It will become too small. See, if I click here, it will come like this. It is too small. For that what I will do is control and select this. I will change into 1:1 scale. So you can place it properly. So here you see, I will drag this and place it outside. Let it be outside the boundary. Later I can retain to the required position. So click on the top view and drag it down like this. So like this I want. Okay. So usually they will ask front view and top view. So let it be front view and top view will be clear like this. Then you can, even it can be a small view. We keep it in 1:2 for this. Like this you can place. Okay, these two is in 1:1 scale, exact scale. This will be in 1:2, half dimension, 50 dimension, 50% scaling is done on this. So you see, in the exam, in manual drawing, you need to draw these two sketches. These two sketches you have to draw in the exam. Okay, so main body, outer boundary, you have to draw. Whatever the inner section, you have to draw this inner section of the main body. So then, so second part will come and sit here, as you know, the bearing bottom off. You have to draw the bearing bottom off, bearing top off, cap. So then bolts. Nut, lock nut, shaft, you have to draw like this. After assembly, how this view, whatever you are seeing the screen now, in the exam manual drawing you have to draw these two. Okay, so first you draw in the part drawing sheet. This sheet will be given for you, this sheet will be given for you. Just copy this and draw the outer boundary. After that, so as I told you, bearing bottom off will come. So you draw this bearing bottom of here, same this thing, bearing top of above this. Then cap you draw, this is the cap. So six, by providing 6 mm gap, as you know, 6 mm gap will be there from axis to this surface. You have to draw this like this. Then you bolt, nut, lock nut, you have to draw. So in the exam you have to draw these two manual sketch after assembly how the front view and top view will be look. So if they ask front view half section, that has to be also shown. If you take this section, what are the hollow part? In hollow part you have to leave it like this. Wherever solid part will come, you have to hatch this. You know this is hollow part, leave it. Here you have to hatch. So here no need to do that circus manually. You already taken section, you need to apply that section. How to apply the section? They ask front view half section, half sectional front view. Okay, only for the front view you have to show the section. So right click on this this, click on this edge, you will box will be appear. Right click on that. Here go to property, you have to go to property, go to property, then in property we have this option, fourth option will be section. So click on the section. By default if it is general, so you have to click on the section, click on the section. Here one section I taken, so click that box. Okay, so then save. Okay, so you are selected section, then save. Okay, so I apply the section. So but view is not updated. After applying the section, you have to again right click on this outer box and you have update view option. So then update this view. So you will get this section like this. Okay, so here only hollow part is there, that's why it is section is not, hatching is not shown. You may ask, sir, this is also hollow part, why the hatching is shown? Because bolt is coming in this hollow space. When bolt is coming, it will become solid. Bolt is solid, it will become solid, that's why it is also hatched. So when compared to left side, here you see it is front view, okay, full view, it is sectional, sectional, half sectional front view. So if you do this much work, you will get a 50 marks. Okay, if you do only assembly and leave it, if you not extracted into 2D sheet, anyway at the end you have to give this printout. Okay, this is the printout you have to submit to the examiner. In this printout they will check, okay, whether this axis is aligned properly, whether 6 mm gap is there. If bolt is not aligned properly, this dotted line and one more dotted line will come like that. This not matching will not be there. Okay, in that scenario we'll come to know what are the error. So the full correction will be done with these two drawing only. Okay, so then after this, even as I already applied the section, you can also see here also in isometric view also you can apply the section here for our understanding purpose. Then you can update view, so you can see here. So this is the updated view. Okay, if you give 1:1 scale, you can clearly see. Okay, so but keep it in 1:2 scale only, and this is not asked. Okay, no need to give this. Okay, section, no need to take section for the isometric view. Okay, only they will ask front view of section, only this much you have to do. Okay, so apply the section and update the view, will get this one. Instead of assembly section, if you select only assembly, then you will not get section. While in drawing view wizard, when you are extracting the drawing, here you have to bring that assembly section, so then only you can get the section. So without PMI, without taking the section on the drawing sheet, okay, after assembly, so if you just simply extract the assembly, you will not get the section. You have to, from with the help of PMI section option, you have to take the section in the assembly sheet. So then save it as assembly section. Then in drawing view wizard, you have to select that assembly section and you have to follow this procedure. So once you complete this, this will be this has to be give by write your name and division here in some space, okay, and take the printout, and this sheet you have to give to the examiner. So this is if you submit this sheet, so without any mistake you done, so you will get 50 marks. Okay, this will complete assembly of plumber block. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.